or a needle, and pick one of the balloons like this. See what happens? We can see that the air has escaped from the other balloon, and the other balloon full of air will bring the scale down to the center. This shows that air has weight. When we blow air into the balloon, we occupy the space with it. Here, my friends, will tell you something more about air. I am going to tell you how air exerts pressure. All we need for this experiment is a glass tumbler and a piece of cardboard. First of all, let's take a glass tumbler filled with water completely. After that, let's place a piece of cardboard or a piece of paper on top of the glass tumbler with your palm or one hand. Like this. And turn it upside down quickly, making sure no air bubbles are present. Let us keep it like this for some time. Now, I will remove my hand. What happens? You will be surprised to see that neither the water nor the cardboard falls down. Why is it so? It's because the air is exerting pressure from below on the cardboard. How is air pressure important in our daily life? Dear parents, most of you must have taken an injection. A syringe is used for this by the doctors. Air pressure is used to push the medicine. Air pressure is used to pull the medicine into the space provided here where the handle is put, like this. A common lift pump also works on the same principle. When we drink Coke or Fanta using a straw, we use pressure. Thus, air pressure is important in our daily life.
In this experiment, we are going to see that does the air support combustion or not. Combustion means fire needs oxygen to burn. We all know that air is made up of different gases such as oxygen, nitrogen, carbon dioxide, etc. Things we need for this experiment are two candles and a glass tumbler. Now, take two candles and light them.
Yeah. Sit down. Please.
This needle is not frozen. Why is this so? It is because the weight of the needle and the force by which it is easily dropped. Thank you. Welcome once again. Now I'm going to tell you about water pressure. All we need are tall jar with tiny 14 holes on the walls at different heights. Now I'm going to fill the jar with water.
One by one.
It shows that liquid exerts pressure. It also shows that pressure at a point in a liquid depends on the depth of the liquid. And the pressure at a point and the pressure increases with the depth of the liquid. Good afternoon. I'm going to tell you the density of salt water. Here we have 5 jars.
Lovely.
First jar contains fresh water and rest 4 contains. What do you see? You see the eggs floating at different levels. Why? It is because of the salt content or the density of the solution. Thank you. Good afternoon. I'm going to tell you about how carbon dioxide
turns.
Whereas plants take in carbon dioxide and give out oxygen. Let's take a little bit of lime water in a test tube. Let's start blowing into the test tube. After some times, we can see that the lime water starts to become cloudy. If we still blow, it will.
Water flows from high level to a low level. Things we need are round bottom flask, 2 hole rubber stopper, fitted with 2 glass tube, 2 rubber tube, 2 buckets, 1 eye filled with colored water, and another to collect the water, and 1 stand to hold the flask. Now let's see what happens. When we connect 1 rubber tube from the bucket to the flask, I'm going to suck the water. We see the fountain of colored water rising up. Air is already there. It has to go out, so air push the water out. Thank you.
Our body, 100% water important, you know, you can eat.
Or people, like fruits, some things are edible. We can take few examples as potato, garlic, ginger, onion, and yam. The water mineral sauce is carried by stems to other parts of the plant. Similarly, the food from the leaves is also taken by the stem to the other parts of the plant. Now, I am going to tell you about the branches. Branches are the offshoot of the stem. They grow in many directions to give shape to the plant. On the branches, leaves grow.
As we all need oxygen and food to live,
Likewise, a seed needs some favorable conditions to grow. They are oxygen, water, and suitable temperature. Germination of a gram seed. The gram is a dicot seed. The seed is covered by a brown seed coat, which gives necessary protection to the embryo. The embryo consists of two white fleshy bodies known as cotyledons. These cotyledons or seed leaves are attached to a short axis. The part of the axis that is facing towards the seed is called the radicle. As the seed germinates, the radicle develops into the root system and the plumule into the shoot system. Food modules are stored within the cotyledons. The radicle gets the food from the cotyledons and begins to grow. Hence, germination of the base seed is hypo.
Well, you can see there is lots of water. Where there is no proper amount of air for the seeds, that's why the seeds not germinate. The second vessel you can see the proper amount of air and correct temperature, and there is no water, the seeds do not germinate. In the third vessel you can see the proper amount of water and air, but as I get it enough out. Thank you. Now my friend Nita will tell you about electric bell. Good afternoon, everybody. Today I'm going to tell you about the electric bell. I think all of you have electric bells in your home, but do you know how it works? So today I'm going to tell you about it. Electromagnets are used in many devices such as relay, automatic, and cutout. The electric bell is a simple and common plugging connected to the terminal T1 and other to the armature. The armature consists of a soft iron rod mounted on a springy bit of steel, and the other end of which presses against the surface of the contact existing screw. The screw is joined to the other terminal T1.
But it reaches the earth in about 8 minutes. The solar system is like a big family. It consists of the sun, 9 planets, 34 satellites or moons, hundreds of astronauts. The planets revolve around the sun and the moons revolve around the planet. There are 9 planets. They are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, and Pluto. Mercury is nearest to the Sun, but Pluto is furthest away. Our Earth is third from the Sun. Mercury is the smallest, and Jupiter is the largest. Saturn has a ring around it. Like the planets, the moons do not have their own light, but reflect sunlight. Our Earth has only one moon. Jupiter has 12 moons.
Boss,
thank you.
Thank you.
Spinning on its axis from west to east, like this. This movement of the Earth is called rotation. It takes 24 hours. Rotation of our Earth causes days and night. The model of the Earth is called globe. The axis, the rod which passes through the globe, is called the axis. The axis of the Earth is tilted. The side which faces the sun has day and the side which is turned away from the sun has night. So the Earth receives light and heat from the sun. If the Earth did not rotate, one half of it would be in continuous darkness and other half of
this vapor rises up and it turns into millions of tiny drops of water. These tiny drops of water float in the air and they get mixed with impurities in the air, thus forming clouds. As the clouds go higher and higher, when they reach a certain place where they cannot hold or absorb more water, then finally they fall down as rain. This rainwater flows into rivers, lakes, and comes back to the sea. And this is called the water cycle. You can see here also. This is sea clouds, rainstorm.
Good afternoon. We are going to show you an experiment all about water. The things we need are a Y cause B curve, a tripod stand, a split lamp, a steel plate, and a match box. First of all, let's take some ice in a beaker, then place it over the tripod stand. Now let's light a split lamp and place it under the stand. Let's wait for some time. Due to heat, ice turns into water. Again, let's wait for some time. Water starts boiling and turns into vapor. Now let's take a steel plate and place it over the beaker. Again, let's wait for some time.
Answer is there, brother. Why did you come to the test?
To walk faster, to make our work easier, and to change the direction of a force. All big and complicated machines are made of different combinations of the super machines. Now let's take an example. Lever, crowbar. Wheel in the axle, steering wheel of a car on kite ship. Screw. Screw is used for lifting a car. The wedge. Knife for an axe for cutting or chopping wood. That's all. Thank you. Now my friend Tashi Kante will tell you about the lever. Good afternoon. I'm going to tell you something about the lever. Lever is simply a waterproof or metal which can move about a fixed point. With the help of lever, we can lift a heavy load by applying a lift force called effort. The force that you see in the lever is called effort, and weight that is to move is called the load. The point on the lever that does not move is called fulcrum. When the effort is applied to the lever, it helps to lift the load. This can be shown by a simple experiment. Now let's take a food ruler and place it on a block of wood. At one end of the ruler,
thank you. question to Group D. What do you call a male goose? A male goose. Right, gander. Secretes juices and hormones. What part of the digestive system secretes digestive juices and hormones? Sorry? What part of the human digestive? Past? Which part of the human body produces colostrum? Wrong. Now the question goes to Group A. Which part of the human body produces colostrum?
Right answer is 20.